On this week's Xamarin Show, I'm going to show you how to wirelessly deploy to your iOS device from Mac or PC. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and today I'm going to show you how to wirelessly deploy to your iOS device from your Mac or PC. Now, this is really cool because traditionally you'd have to come over to your Mac, plug in all these cables, and then your iOS device would show up inside of Visual Studio for Mac or Visual Studio 2017 on your PC, as long as kind of everything's on the same network. Now, what's unique is that Apple enabled a new functionality to enable iOS devices and Apple TV devices, in fact, all their devices, to be able to connect to the Mac over Wi-Fi. And then we enabled it so you could debug to that device once paired over Wi-Fi. So that means you can just rip the cables and you'll be done forever. But first, you're gonna have to plug it in. So let's take a look at what it looks like on a traditional, normal day without enabling any of this. And then we'll enable Wi-Fi. So let's head over to the Mac. Now here I am inside of Visual Studio for Mac. And I have an iOS and Android project. And we can go ahead and zoom in here and see in my debug, I have all of my iOS simulators, and then my iPhone device. We see a little iPhone device here, and if I had an iPad or an Apple TV that was plugged in via USB, I would be good to go. Now, the problem here is that you have to keep plugging the device in over and over and over again, and sometimes you just want to deploy to what's in your hand today or be able to easily swap in and out. Or in the case of me, with my MacBook Adorable, I only have one USB port. So let's enable Wi-Fi debugging. So what we're going to do first is actually close down Visual Studio for Mac, because the first step is to enable debug mode for this iPhone inside of Xcode. So we're going to launch Xcode, and I'm going to go to Window, and then here we're going to see Devices and Simulators. This is sort of a one-stop shop to see kind of what's installed on your device, pair devices to your physical iPhone device, and get unique identifiers or serial numbers. Now, when you plug this in, Xcode will provision your device, but also you'll see a new option say connect via network. All you have to do just once is say connect via network. It's literally that easy. So now what I'm going to do over here is we're going to go ahead and take this device and unplug it. That's it. It's gone. So let's hop back over to the Mac and see what happened now that I've actually ripped that cable out. Now notice that, hey, I'm still here inside of the device manager, but my iPhone has this little network device. And this is because I'm on the same network. You could have your Mac or PC wired, or you can be on the same Wi-Fi like I am here. Now I see everything exactly the same, but it's here. That means that if I come now back over into Visual Studio for Mac, when I zoom in, we will see down here that I see my device, iPhone, we've added a little Wi-Fi symbol there. So that means now I can select that iPhone device and simply hit debug. As long as I'm provisioned, I'm good to go. I am now wirelessly debugging over Wi-Fi. So now what's cool is that I can go beyond the Mac and I can head over to my Windows PC inside of Visual Studio 2017 and get the same exact experience. So let's head over there. So here I am inside of Visual Studio 2017. Now, what's cool here, of course, is I have debug, iPhone, iPhone simulator, and with iPhone selected, here it is, iPhone connected via network. Now, the name of my iPhone is iPhone, but it would show any of your name that you have for your device. You can, of course, see all of your other simulators or other devices connected via network, and this is because I'm connected via the paired process. So you still have to enable that. But once all of your devices are paired and on the same network, you're good to go. All your devices are done. It's it. It's literally that simple to get started over Wi-Fi debugging to your iOS device. And this is super important because the latest generation of Apple TVs actually have no kind of USB output. You have to actually do this always over Wi-Fi. So there you have it. Super simple. I hope that you enjoy this. And now you can start Wi-Fi debugging all the time for your iOS devices. So that's going to do it. I will put links to our documentation in case you stumble into any issues. But of course, feel free to contact me on Twitter at James Montemagno. So until next time, this has been the Xamarin Show. I'm James, and thanks for watching.